Georgia State, where tuition is handled by some random nigga that live in Atlanta that she only see when she feels obligated. Admitted it to me the first time we dated, but she...
And folks, here we go. We are live. Back to action here at the Chandler Gilbert Baseball Field. Apologies for the technical difficulties to start us off, but he didn't miss much. In the top of the first, we saw Gavin Park just decimate this ACU JV squad. And listen, that's a great start from Gavin, exactly what I expected to see from him. And now let's look into the box. Batting leadoff for the Coyotes is number two, Aiden Krause today. 1-1 count as that pitch goes low. And we'll dial up the starting rotation for this ACU infield and outfield, as this one is fouled off. A good hack from Krause, and he's all over it right now. So if you tuned in yesterday, you saw a wonderful matchup between the Yotes and the Bears, in which the Yotes clutched up in the bottom of the eighth inning, posting a five spot, and then shutting things down in the top of the ninth with Sugar Shane Anderson. And, you know, joining us today, none other than the legendary, highly touted, professional Joey P. Joe Pequeno will be on the mic shortly as we set things up. And we've got ourselves a 2-2 count here. Andres on the bump. And the 2-2 goes low, so we've worked ourselves into a full count. And we now welcome our main man, Joey P, onto the airways. Joey P, how we doing?
Doing good. This one lifted deep left, and this one is off the wall. And wow, going to third base is Aiden Krause with a stand-up triple. And that is a good way to start. And let me just say, as Krause gets the Coyotes going in such the right direction, smacky one deep off the wall in left field, that the whole time that Adam Perry was giving me such a great lead in, he was manipulating the equipment, getting everything in order, and that is how polished he is as a broadcaster now, is that he's able to do so many things, multitask, and manage to say sound so perfect on the air. So now stepping in is Jackson Reed, followed by Trey Medina. And this is a Coyotes team coming in 41 games into the season, and this is kind of a little bit of a late season reset for the team as they come into this matchup against ACU, the Firestorm. Chandler Gilbert, 27-14 overall, 16-12, leading the Region 1 right now. And Doc, it's a good time for the Coyotes to get some youngsters some playing time. This one shot up the middle, the play at first, and how about the bang, bang play, and they're going to call Jackson Reed out and give credit where credit's due on the great play by the shortstop, Aaron Newcomb, who ranged deep to his left and threw over for the putout.
Yeah, that was awesome. Obviously, the run still scores, so it's an RBI for Jackson Reed. He gets picked up by his teammates, but definitely an interesting call there on the play at first. Tremendous play from the shortstop, no doubt, though. First pitch is off the plate.
Checking in, Trey Medina. 381 on the year. He's got one home run, 9 RBIs. Facing the lefty, first pitch. That one's inside. So, Doc, you've seen a lot more games than I have, and we're starting to get to the crunch point of the season where the games, the lights get bigger, the at-bats, every pitch is magnified. 27-14 as this one is smashed to left center, and good at-bat by Trey Medina. Quality base knock, a single left center. Now stepping in is Amir McGee. So 27-14 as the sophomore steps in from the Fighting City of Philadelphia. Give us your take on this team right now and what they have to do to get over the hump and win the region.
Yeah, Joe, I mean, it's been a pretty good season thus far. And, you know, one of the things we've noticed is as the season has progressed, the Yotes have slowly but surely become more refined. And, you know, yesterday we saw some early errors, but, you know, heading down the stretch of the game, the Yotes have started to activate that clutch factor, and that's exactly what you want to see heading into the playoff stretch, is a team that can just make wins happen. And a play at second here, the throwdown, is in time, but not handled well by the second baseman. And it's a stolen bag for Trey Mandina. So for the Yotes yesterday, it was a little bit sloppy at first, but after the first three innings, I mean, they just turned it on.
Mandina showing what he can do, his fourth stolen base, and the team really taking care of business against Phoenix College. So the squad is riding a four-game winning streak. And, of course, John Watson, the coach of Chandler Gilbert, feels that some early games were given away in conference play. But, honestly, from top to bottom, this league is so tough that a couple plays here and there could swing either way. So now it's the crunch point of the season as this team is now taking on the firestorm, and then they go back to work. And work is what they need to do to try to get the top seed. And as Amir lifts one to center, and this one is going to drop, turning the corner and holding right there. And Amir thought about it, faked, and goes back to first base. So right now, a lot of good contact by the Coyotes at the dish.
Yeah. So. Great stuff, and especially for Amir, it's great to see him get back on the horse. It's been a little bit rough for him at the plate so far this season, but one thing I've noticed about Amir McGee is every single time after the game I walk down there, he is in the cage getting extra reps after every game, after every practice. The kid is just a hard worker, so good to see him turning the corner.
Stepping in, David Bull, the freshman, hitting 230, looking to get a good quality AB here. So after tonight, it gets serious. Going to Mesa in a big road and home series. This one bounced to second. Second baseman gets the out at second and can't deliver on the throw to first, but a run comes in. So good contact by David Bull and a good play by the second baseman, Alexi Roman, who got the put out at second base. So one out for the Coyotes. Make that two. And now stepping into the box is DJ Barrett, the DH. Barrett checking in, hitting 385. Lifts one to right field. The right fielder battling the sun out there and makes the grab, but the Coyotes put it in the bottom of the first. Good start for the home team. We'll go to the second inning. You're watching the Coyotes right here on the Chandler Gilbert Sports Network. Yeah, I'm up at Brooklyn. Now I'm down in Tribeca, right next to the Narrow. But I'll be hood forever. I'm the new Sinatra. And since I made it here, I can make it anywhere. Yeah, they love me everywhere. I used to cop in Harlem. All of my Dominicanos right there up on Broadway. Pulled me back to that McDonald's. Took it to my stash spot, 560 State Street. Catch me in the kitchen like a Simmons whipping pastry. Cruising down A Street, off white Lexus. Driving so slow, but BK is from Texas. Me, I'm up at Bed-Stuy, home of that boy Biggie. Now I live on Billboard, and I brought my boys with me. Say what up to Tata, still sipping my top. Sitting courtside, Knicks and Nets give me high five. I be spiked out, I could trip a referee. Tell by my attitude that I most definitely from. Gavin Park going into his second inning of work. The sophomore played his high school ball at Chaparral High, 1-0 on the season. ACU looking to make some noise here in the East Valley. Of course, ACU located up the I-17, Firestorm. You name it, they're good in just about every single program on their campus. And Park starts with the slow bender. Up at the dish is Harness. And Harness with a big cut and swings right through it. Ryan Harness, the right fielder. So Gavin Park, good first inning, got out of it. And now it's Harness, followed by Jacob Pickering and Josh Kazeel. Another bender, and this one is ripped foul down the first base line. Great day for baseball. Finally getting into that kind of weather where you're getting some 6 o'clock games. Mother Nature playing nice. Chamber of Commerce weather, and this one just fouled off as Harness just got a piece. And Park is showing a nasty bender early in this one. So the beautiful thing about Adam Perry, who's got the luxury of getting home cooking, is that he comes to the ballpark, he's got his plastic Tupperware, and his mom made these, no question, these great chicken quesadillas. Am I right?
You're spot on, Joe. Absolutely. And, you know, my mother has a tremendous talent for cooking, and I got to say, chicken quesadillas, they might be easy to make, but she put some amazing touches on it. So, you know, if you ever hear me disappear for a few seconds or minutes, I might be munching on a quesadilla.
Yeah, and you know the greatest thing about a chicken quesadilla?
What's that?
Is when someone else is making them.
Exactly.
When all you've got to do is be the recipient.
Yeah.
2-2 pitch, Gavin Park to Harness. Fastball misses outside, goes to 3-2. So, Doc, we kind of touched on it. 27-14, your thoughts of where Chandler Gilbert is right now?
Yeah, I mean, I just think they're doing everything right heading down the stretch, and they're starting to exhibit that X factor a team needs to have to make a deep playoff run, as this one is fouled off straight past us. But, I mean, they're doing everything right, Joe. Their practices haven't changed. Everything is still intense for these boys, and listen, they know what's coming, and they're ready for it.
3-2 count. Here it is. A little off speed, and Harness just gets a piece, fouls it off. Keeps it at 3-2. And supposedly we might have a Paulo Hutchinson visit tonight.
Wow.
He said he might be bringing what is becoming a specialty, Brooklyn V's Pizza, but you're set and situated.
You know, I might have to make some extra room in the stomach for tonight, as this ball was crushed to deep right field. Ryder's tracking back near the warning track, almost makes a grab as it one hops almost over the fence. He gets it in. And it's going to be a play at third. Tiggs will hold it, and it'll be a sliding triple right there on a 3-2 count.
Ryan Harness just misses getting one out of here. Waited back on a bender and timed it perfectly and lifted it deep right and gave a good chase. And Jackson Reed could not bring it in. So now it's an opportunity for Jacob Pickering, the first baseman. Outfield playing medium depth, infield playing straight up the middle. Gavin Park, first pitch, slow bender. And that can be a devastating pitch, Doc, but it's also about location on where you're spotting it. And the pitch before to Harness, just a bad spot, and Harness was all over it.
Absolutely. Counts play a huge role, especially with pitch selection. And right there, that one's fouled off, another bender. Now an 0-2. He has a whole lot of options he can go to here. He can triple up if he wanted to, but I have a feeling he might go to a fastball here.
0-2 pitch, Park. And Doc called it. This one lifted down the third base line and coming in. And how about the near grab and a good solid effort over there by Kyle Anderson. Just could not haul it in. You get all that momentum coming in, Doc, and then sometimes you just overrun the play, and that's exactly what happened there for Anderson. But an A for effort, just cannot haul it in for the execution. So it remains 0-2. So, Doc, I know you continue to follow your Castile Colts. How are they doing this year?
I mean, they're doing great. They're at the NHSI right now, and they're balling out over there. Mason Russell, as Gavin gets a swinging K and a laugh from the batter. But Castile, they just had a no-hitter yesterday thanks to Mason Russell, their premier left-handed pitcher. And listen, I got to play alongside him when he was a freshman and a sophomore. The kid is legit, and he'll be getting drafted in this upcoming draft for sure.
Josh Kazeel stepping in. So That's got to be exciting for him and his family and that whole area. Anytime a kid that can come out of high school and gets that kind of notoriety and gets his name selected in the Major League Baseball draft. And the way you look at it, it's not so much where you go. It's what you do with the opportunity when you get there.
Exactly. Absolutely. Park misses inside on a bender right there. We go to 1-1. So with one out, a runner on third, no runs across, Park can still work out of this mess.
1-1 pitch, slow bender, working that, chop to third base, Anderson. And Anderson can't handle it as Harness comes in. And Gazeel works his way on the error. So a run is in, and now it's a 2-1 ball game. And Doc, Anderson also is a pitcher on this team. So, look, he probably doesn't get those regular reps at third base, so he's getting an opportunity to play a little bit of the field today. So maybe just getting adjusted, a little fish out of water.
Yeah, absolutely.
The hops and everything else.
Yeah, definitely. And, you know, practice reps and game scenarios are a whole lot different, especially when you're actually on the field. So for him, probably just shaking some rust off, hasn't seen the field too much over at third base this season, and just got to brush those off and get back to it.
Stan King, the DH, another lefty. They're packing him in this firestorm lineup. And, Doc, when you used to hurl the heat for Castile, did you like throwing against left-handed batters?
You know, listen, I like to throw lefty or righty. Didn't matter, as this one is scorched to the right side off the glove of David Bull, and that'll sneak all the way to Jackson Reed in right field. He'll hold the runner on second, so we've got ourselves first and second here with one out. But, you know, back when I was on the mound for Castile, I had no preference because I could go change up away, slider in, and, you know, I like to work both sides of the plate, really. That was my specialty, was in and out, in and out.
And that's always the great kind of execution, get the hitters thinking, and they can't dial up on a certain part of the plate.
Yeah.
Stepping in the catcher, Joey Thomas with a couple on. Gavin Park trying to wiggle his way out of this one. This one, high chopper. Anderson's got an opportunity. And they turn it. How about Anderson getting
well
some
done.
Work at third base? They do it the old-fashioned way. They turn two, and we'll go to the bottom half of the second. 2-1 ball game, Coyotes and Firestorm.
Time it is, no guarantees. When I was broke, she was being a tease. Four pockets full, now she's down on her knees. Whoa, 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 whoa. Baby, gon' hit it and send it to me. Yeah. Or I'ma hit it and send it to baby. That's how I get when it's like get you crazy. Whoa, whoa, for real, for real. Whoa. They tryna sell the deal. See me up under a sheet, parade in the streets. Yeah. Try me 100 times. Wanted me to lie, wanted me to cry, wanted me to die.
Bottom of the second. Blake Tiggis followed by Kyle Anderson and Keegan Ball. Tiggis, young man who just flats out, knows how to get on base, and such a valuable member of this Coyotes team. Just really knows how to go deep in counts. He's hitting 277, but the on-base percentage is 484. And that speaks volumes because, Doc, essentially, if you're getting on every other opportunity, you're giving your back end and the top of the order a chance to knock you in.
Absolutely. And, you know, Tiggs is one of those guys that's just a scrappy warrior for this team. And he's a coach's dream and a player. You want a kid that's going to come out every day, give 120%. And he just gets on. He finds a way.
2-1 count. Big bender. That misses upstairs. Goes to 3-1. Kyle Anderson on deck. Once again, the only thing missing from Chandler Gilbert is the concession stand. The hot dogs and some beverages and maybe that that ice cream cone with the chocolate and the nuts on top.
Yep. Yeah, no, I mean.
Or how about the all traditional blow pop as well, right? The red, white, and blue pop.
Hard to go wrong with it. And honestly, I hope there's some businessman or entrepreneur tuning in. This could be a potential venture for you if you want to come out to Chandler Gilbert and establish something. But a pop out to the second baseman will retire Kyle Anderson, and that'll bring up Keegan Ball.
Keegan Ball, the freshman. Limited at-bats, so he's getting his opportunity tonight. And you know he's excited to show what he can do in front of the home crowd. Throw over, and Blake gets back easily. And for Keegan Ball, Doc, when you've only played sparingly, and you're so amped up to play, how do you go about trying to maintain an even balance so you're not over-aggressive at the plate and you've got the ability to control the zone?
Yeah, you know, I think it helps these boys a little bit today that, you know, it's not necessarily a conference matchup they're going to. So they know the stakes aren't as high as, let's say, a winner-go-home type of game. But even with that, you know, being on the field, it's going to be under the lights here pretty shortly. You have to come in composed. You have to practice for it. And I'm sure in their pregame reps, they were imagining these moments right now. So 2-1 now. That one catches the bottom of the zone. And a good approach from Baugh so far.
So now he's got a 2-1 count. Second baseman is sneaking towards second base. Now the throw over to first base. Chandler Gilbert decked out in the black tops tonight. ACU, kind of like their Road Warrior gray and black. And this one lifted to center field. Shortstop going back and makes the nice play. Good work by Aaron Newcomb, dropping back and hauling that in. So now we go back to the top of the order. Aiden Krause in the first time up, crush one left field. Former Corona del Sol star, member of the Aztecs baseball team.
And Krause is one of the players here that could very well establish himself back in the starting lineup for this Yodi squad with a great performance here today. I mean, he's a guy that normally is in and out, but, you know, it's just so hard for him to find consistent innings because, you know, the outfield is stacked up, man. You got to put Easton Bryant somewhere. Ryder and Ben got to play. Not a whole lot of options. This one is crushed down the left line, and that's going to be at least a double for Aiden Krause. Tiggs heading around third now. That ball's all the way into the far corner. He'll hold up on third, and it's a double for Aiden Krause to kick things off.
Making the most of the opportunities. You kind of talked about the crowded outfield. So what do you do to work your way in? You produce when you get your chances. And Krause does that, rips a fastball down the line, worked his way into the corner, and Blake holds up at third. So Coyotes threatening, two on, two out. And stepping in, Jackson Reed. Bounced out, got an RBI his first time up. Inside fastball. And Alex Andrus, the lefty. He's got kind of that Raleigh Fingers throwback mustache going. Doc, I don't even think you know who Raleigh Fingers is.
I don't.
Okay.
No.
Classic reliever back in the days. Pitched for the A's in their championship years in the 70s. They had Sal Bando and Reggie Jackson. And at that point, Adam Perry was a twinkle in his parents' eyes.
Yes.
They thought one day we're going to get married and we're going to have a son and we're going to call him Adam and he's going to be special. And that one is fouled off. But needless to say, as I digress, Fingers was a great reliever, and Andrus on the mound's kind of rocking that kind of horseshoe, kind of mustache going out there.
Spectacular stuff, yeah.
Doc, have you ever rocked a mustache in your lifetime?
I probably let it grow for about 3 weeks before my mom shaved it off in my sleep. No, I'm just kidding. But, yeah, no, definitely no facial hair too long for her. She, no way.
So one time I was in Atlanta, and I grew a full-blown beard.
Wow, I couldn't even picture you with the beard, Joe.
I went out one night, and it was like 2 o'clock in the morning. I looked in the mirror, and I said, oh, my goodness. And this one shot up the middle, and this one gets through. One run is in. Another is coming down. And how about Jackson Reed? 2-run single, and the Coyotes are up 4-1. See ball, hit ball, and that one was placed perfectly. A bullet between the 6 and 4 hole to knock in 2.
You know, that's just tremendous work, and you can talk about timely hitting all day long. That's a perfect example. 2 outs, 2 runners in scoring position, and talk about cashing in right there.
Trey Medina stepping in, singled his first time up. Bender misses way outside. So it was 2 o'clock in the morning. I got a full facial beard going, and I just took a moment to reflect, and I said, man, my goodness, I look like the Wolfman. And then I shaved immediately.
Yeah.
It had to be gone. It was a mess. I didn't look anything like I envisioned myself, and I just said no more. So all these people, you know, they go with kind of like the scrappy beards and I can't do it. I just can't. This one lifted foul down the right field line.
Yeah, I have to say the clean-shaven look sports you well, Joe. You sport it well, that is.
Yeah, well, every day, first thing in the morning, break out the electric, and then do the rest with a little razor, just kind of
clean it up,
dry shave and get it done. 2-1 count, Andrus, Trey Medina, and Trey fouls one off, evens the count at 2 apiece. Good crowd on hand once again for all Coyotes fans out there, all Coyotes athletic events, free to the public.
Free.
Yeah, so if you've got some youngsters you need to entertain, they've been bottled up around the house, driving you nuts all day, take them to a baseball game.
Yeah.
That one misses outside. And the Coyotes would love the fan support as they are heading toward the most crucial point of the season. And, Doc, I mean, we were here at this point last year gearing up for the postseason, and you can feel the adrenaline building for this team as each game is going to get bigger and the stakes are going to get bigger as the team is once again playing for the number one seed in Region 1. 3-2 pitch. And Medina waves through it and the throw down, and that's going to do it. But the Coyotes on the clutch contact of Jackson Reed. 2 more come in, 4-1 game after 2. And once again, if you're just coming to Chandler Gilbert, if you've got your dance shoes on, you need them. Because we're kicking the house music in a big way.
Adam Perry dialing up the hits that you want to dance to and get your music onto. So we go to the third inning. Gavin Park is still on the bump. He surrendered one run so far. Checking in, the second baseman, Alexi Roman. So the Coyotes doing what's necessary in this kind of break between conference games. And this one is shot down the left field line. Roman turning one, and how about Amir getting to it quickly to hold him to a single. So Doc, from a team perspective for the Coyotes, do they enjoy the little mental break and it's kind of maybe a sigh of relief from the conference play and the grind of it?
Absolutely. I mean, I know these guys would be first to, you know, dive head first into more competition, but whether they realize it or not, these kind of breaks are great for them as a team, especially to recharge and regroup. So first pitch will miss inside, and Gavin Park is going to have to get back to work here.
Aaron Newcomb at the dish, 0 for 1. Firestorm looking to make some noise, and the JV opportunity. This one straight back. We get a chance. This one is going to bounce up, and a gentleman in the front row. All he had to do was stick out the big bear paw and could have made the play of the day and refused to.
Yeah.
I mean, is that like...
That might be a finable offense here.
Absolutely, right? I mean, does he even play the next five games? I mean, he has to be benched.
Yeah.
You got to make a play on the ball somewhat. 0-1 pitch, and that one gets away from Park. Call that a balk as the runner will move up to second base. And that's rare that you see that. And look, I've seen that in the softball circuit numerous times where a pitcher just loses the release point and the ball gets away, and Park does. So now Roman's down at second base. 0-1 pitch, big bender. And that can really neutralize any batter of that big slow breaking pitch.
Yeah. So 1-2 for Park here.
So Park, Doc, he's got a little bit of that big bender. Fastball, sneaky, right? He tries to spot it. Is that the main two in the arsenal?
So this kid throws a whole bunch of pitches. I would say his main, though, yeah, you got to go breaker and with the heater. Typically with the heater, he's, you know, mid-80s, and it sneaks up well. He has a very high spin rate, so it starts off looking a little slower than it is. This ball is lifted over the shortstop's head. Bach can't reach up and make the grab, so it'll fall for a base knock, but the run won't come across the score. He'll hold up on third. So now a first and third situation for Gavitron here with no outs, and for him, he's just got to get back to keeping things low and away from the hitters right now, leaving a few pitches up and just grooving pitches for the hitters. But outside of that, his stuff looks pretty good today.
Stepping in, Jake Petras, 0 for 1, followed by Luke Killinger. Firestorm making some noise on the top of the third. Runners at the corners. And how about some small ball? Play at first base, and Park knocks it over to get the out. And good execution by the Firestorm as a run crosses the plate and they advance the runner. And I'm big about doing that, Doc, because it's early in the game. You know, you get a run across, and now it's a two-run game.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, a whole lot of baseball left to play, and good on ACU for trying to claw back early. And for Gavin Park, a good play on that PFP right there. And I like the IQ from him to look at second base first. He knows that, you know, it's ideal to get two there, but he'll have to settle for the out at first. Not enough time to turn around and throw it all the way over there. So a smart play, but the Yotes will settle for one out with a runner on second here.
Stepping in is Killinger. He's 0 for 1 as well. He's got an opportunity. Runner at second, outfield, medium depth. Slow bender, outside corner, that misses. Goes to 1-0. Team back at it tomorrow in league play. At Mesa, then a Saturday game at noon. Yours truly, along with Adam Perry, will be on that call. This one, sky to the left side. Under it and making the grab is Keegan Ball for the second out. Now it's Ryan Harness, his first time up, knocked a triple off the wall in right field. Sat back on a bender and took it a long way. Chase Jackson Reed to the warning track, and Reed could not make the play. 4-2 ball game. First pitch to Ryan Harness. Slow bender outside. And it seems like right now, Doc, the way ACU is approaching Gavin Park is they're trying to just sit on the changeup. If they get a good one, that's the pitch they're on, and laying off the fastball.
Yeah, perhaps waiting for an off speed. And Gavin does a good job right there going back to the fastball, but just misses low. So we go to 2-0.
So the beautiful thing about a Chandler Gilbert baseball game, people will break out their phones and FaceTime other people in the course of a ball game. And they'll just have conversations and say what's going on.
They're live on TikTok actually down there.
Yeah.
So they're TikToking it up here at the Chandler Gilbert baseball field. And why not? It's beautiful out here. 3-0 count for Park.
Showing bunt, and Harness does a nice job working the walk. So you got runners at first and second. Jacob Pickering struck out his first time up. And this is an opportunity for Gavin Park to dial it in and work under some adversity. Park coming in limited opportunities. Three appearances, one win, only two innings of work. And this one bounced to the right side. Good hop, and Blake is there, and the throw over. But ACU, they manufacture a run, play a little small ball, getting it across. It's a 4-2 game as we go to the bottom of the third. We're going to go to the bottom of third. Alex Andrus going into his third inning of work has surrendered four runs. Mir McGee, David Bull, and DJ Barrett looking to take their quality hacks. Amir, the fighting filly. Parents are always dialing in. Want to say hi to the McGees out there. Some of the nicest people you'll meet. And loyal followers of Chandler Gilbert baseball and all the broadcasts right here from the East Valley. Amir takes one outside, 1-0 pitch, misses low, goes to 2-0. So Chandler Gilbert, a little bit of a stress relief, kind of a glorified scrimmage for them. Get some players in that maybe not getting the opportunities in the course of the season, and then they're right back at it. Big series against Mesa, Doc, and I know it's early in this one, of course, but when you think about Mesa and those two teams are chasing each other for the top seed, what's kind of the mindset going into Mesa and then Mesa coming here on Saturday?
Yeah, well, the Yotes know what to expect when you play Mesa, and that is just a plethora of small ball and pressure. Mesa is so good at applying pressure in every situation, offensively, defensively. They're just going to pressure you as a team, and it works out pretty well for them. Amir slams this one over to the right side, and that's a good hit from him off the top of the wall on the hop. He's headed around first. He'll hold up on second base. Amir McGee, two-hit day. This time it's a double as he tosses a nade towards the Yodi dugout.
And you love to see that for Amir, because here's a young man, always got a smile on his face, works hard, puts the time and effort in, and you like to see him wrap up his Coyotes career on a positive and maybe have the opportunity to play somewhere next year as well.
Absolutely, for that kid. I mean, he is just a hard worker. He's a coach's dream of a player, a great family guy, great culture guy to have around. But make no mistake, Amir McGee is here to play baseball, and he is making his mark felt today.
Stepping in, David Bull. Got robbed of a hit on a great play by Roman at second base. His first time up. 0-1 count. Roman playing a little chess game with Amir at second. This one lifted to left, and this one is going to drop in as McGee goes 90 feet to third base. And Doc, in that situation right there, that ball held up a long time. If you're the coach, do you have a conversation with the left fielder after that play?
Yeah, absolutely. He might have misread it, but there was a lot of time where he was just standing there waiting for that ball to hop in front of him. And I'm sure he realized his mistake after the ball hit the ground. But definitely a conversation to be had there. Barrett slams this one over to the right side. And in the sun, the right fielder makes a nice grab. Amir will score on the tag. And it's a sacrifice fly for DJ Barrett. So a positive in the scorebook for him. And the Yotes attack on another run. The score now, Coyotes 5 to ACU's 2. And still a runner on first base for the Yotes here with one out. Blake Tiggs comes to the plate.
Blake walked his first time up. We talked about Blake, his on-base percentage, almost 500. Andrus with the big bender that misses outside. So Mesa, the Coyotes can expect a lot of small ball, great fundamental execution.
Yes.
And that's a bender that dots the corner, evens the count at 1-1.
And they have a tremendous bullpen as well, which when you talk about winning teams, that is always a factor. 1-1 lifted to the left side. A chance on it for the third baseman, and he cannot make it all the way. That one drops almost near the Coyote bullpen. So quite a long journey for the third baseman and the left fielder. He can cover some ground, I'll tell you what.
And Josh Kazeel, the third baseman, just racked up some frequent flyer miles going from third base trying to track that one down. Ended up in Colorado, now has worked his way back to third base. It's a 1-2 count. Andrus, look at the runner at first. This one knocked up the middle, off the glove, and it's a one bounce and the throw over. And
wow.
Courtesy of Andrus on the deflection. Credit at 1-6. And 3 for the double play. But the Coyotes tack on another run. It's a 5-2 ball game going to the fourth. I took a ballerina down to the ball dance. Met a couple ball players, found a ball stance. Now we in the bathroom, she found a ball face. Took some shots and balled out, now how the stall tastes. I can't even go inside my own mic here. I might need to hit the town, I need you right here, right here. Till she reached in the trunk and found a Nina. I told her, baby, that's Nina Simone. Hey, driving through the liquor store, faded, braided, hands in this waving, AZ, 80s like the 90s and 2000s. Driving through this wildin', hey, Brady 7 pack, they come in bunch. I've been with the choir on a high note, getting C notes. Different presentation to this vibe, you need a keynote. Prezi around this. Sending vetoes, ain't no stopping. The stopping lick some boys on Geo. Batting up the 504, I say the name is Creole. Dallas, when I'm on the road, I get to go in T.O. Dominatrix matrix when she do it like I'm Neo. This other side gets they locking. Mama said, live up to my name, but they jocking. They gon' try, go and take your face for the profit. They gon' lie, they gon' slip and slide, get beside you. They gon' try. And we go to the fourth inning, Gavin Park, still on the bump. Like to welcome in the Noli family. Kathy Noli, the proud mom of Danny Noli, a pitcher on the baseball team, and his sister on hand, Cheyenne, a member of the Chandler High softball team, a star. She is going to play softball for the Utah Utes. This one bounced to short, good hop, and the throw over, a bullet. Just like that, easy work And the good toss by Keegan Ball for the first out here in the fourth inning. Stepping in, Stan King singled his first time up. King, the DH, looking to provide a spark here for ACU. Takes one low in the dirt. And Doc, kind of give me the sense of home plate. It's not, is it clay? Is it kind of glorified rubber? What is it? Because the makeup, we know the infield is all clay.
Yeah.
But give us kind of the breakdown of the bump and the batter's box.
Yeah, so I mean, the pitching mound is all turf except the actual rubber. The landing spot is a little cutout of turf, so it's easier to replace. And over at home plate, it's all turf except for the rubber plate, which is why we've seen some crazy hops on curveballs and whatnot. Sometimes they bounce way up off the front of the lip of the plate, and you know, they have it sunk in a little bit to the ground to try and prevent that, but it's pretty much inevitable to, you know, sometimes hit the lip. And we go to 3-1 as that pitch misses high. But you know, I gotta tell you, coming from playing on dirt your whole life to making the switch to turf is a little difficult, especially as a pitcher. It definitely takes a few live outings to get used to. This one is skied over to the left side, out of play, but Kyle Anderson is there to make the grab. So two down here in the top of the fourth. Good work for Gavin Park. And it seems he's adjusted to the turf mound pretty well.
And remember back in the days of Little League Doc where you step in the batter's box and there would be such a hole.
Oh, my goodness.
And you're literally entrenched trying to find a spot to, like, get a good balance to get your footwork in order to take a good quality hack, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Park misses outside on the first pitch, and stepping in is Joey Thomas, the catcher. Bounced into a 6-4-3 double play his first time up. Park in his fourth inning of work, the sophomore, and this one bounced to short. Keegan Ball, in between hop, throws over, long stretch, and he gets him. Keegan Ball. Ball played him. He decided to play the ball and go the other way. Good work by Gavin Park. We go to the lower half. Coyotes with a 5-2 lead. Bottom four, Kyle Anderson, Keegan Ball, and Aiden Krause. Lefty is still on the mound as this one is fouled straight back. Alex Andrus, he's given up 5. Through 3, now trying to make it through the fourth and keep the firestorm in this one. 0-1 pitch, that one off the turf. But Doc, needs to say, whether it be the bump or at the plate, you get some good quality hops. There's no really, you don't have to worry about a bad hop coming up and taking one off the chest or even the face when you, you know, you're going to get a clean hop off the turf. And a lot of fields now in collegiately over at Legacy Fields, where home of Park University Gilbert, they play on turf fields over there. And they get nice clean hops on the softball fields and the baseball fields over there. High chopper, and this one is a gift. And tomorrow in the box score, he's going to say, bullet down the left field line.
Yep. No difference. Base knock. Gets the job done.
Keegan Ball checking in. Popped a short his first time up. So Alex Andrus making his way through the lower half of the order for the Coyotes. Big bender misses upstairs, and Ball laying off. Aiden Krause on deck, and Krause on his way to a really nice day. Tripled in the first, doubled in the second. But first, it's Keegan Ball. Slow bender. And Doc, give us kind of a hitter's perspective. When you're facing a pitcher like Andrus, what it takes to wait on a bender and knock it the other way.
Yeah, you know, the Yotes have seen a lot of flamethrowers so far this season. This is definitely a change in speed for them. And, you know, they get to practice every different speed on a hitting machine, so it's not too far off base for them. But, you know, you really have to understand how to control your weight and just not look at a cookie and lose your mind over it. You got to wait for it to come to you. So these boys know that. A lot of practice. But even still, a slower pitcher is often more deceitful in the box, especially if you're used to, you know, low to mid-90s. So for the Yotes, definitely an adjustment to be made there. 2-2.
And Ball lifts this one left. Left fielder Killinger right there, and that will surrender Keegan. Gave it a ride, just got under it. Now it's Aiden Krause, the pride of Corona del Sol, the former Aztec. And luckily for me, my daughter attends Corona. We live about 3 blocks away. So that's an
convenient,
an easy stroll for her to get to school. She's driving now.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
And she loves to, like, give everyone a ride home.
Does insurance know that she's driving yet, or?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, we have to pay for that, right?
Of course, yeah.
Can't gamble on that.
No.
But she'll make the pit stops at Starbucks and everyone else. Slow bouncer to third. The force out at second, and the throw over is safe at first. So Aiden Krause on a fielder's choice. And he's at first base.
So now it's Jackson Reed stepping into the box. With 2 outs and a man on first, still an opportunity to make something happen for the Yotes.
Reed last time up, little clutch contact with 2 runners on, base knock up the middle, drove in 2. Part of that 2-run second inning. 0-1 pitch, misses upstairs. Great night for baseball underneath the lights. Getting to the point where Mother Nature is starting to whisper, the heat is coming. And this one, driven to left. Killinger going back and drop steps perfectly and brings it in. Coyotes make some noise. They strand a runner. We go to the next frame. They are leading 5-2.
Just to you, we die. I wanna run.
Club membership has its privileges. If you're just dialing into the dance club, we like to kick it pretty hard. We dialed up for your dancing and rhythm pleasure. Gavin Park now working into his fifth inning of work. And the young man, the sophomore, Doc, he's mixed in that fastball with a good breaking pitch, and for the most part, it's keeping ACU off balance. Stepping in, Alexi Roman singled his first time up, takes a strike. Firestorm. Program up the I-17. They recruit well in state. Got a JV program here that's looking to make some noise. A lot of these guys trying to earn their way onto the varsity roster. 1-1 count. Misses upstairs. And Doc, for a lot of these JV players on ACU, how important is it for them on a day-to-day basis to produce, to show the members of the varsity squad that they're belonging?
Yeah, well, ultra important. And, you know, today is almost like a Super Bowl type of thing for them. This is a huge opportunity for all of these players on ACU JV squad to make a big statement. And, you know, some of them already have. So good for them on seizing the moment, capitalizing on opportunity. This one driven up the middle. Keegan Hassett flips it over to first, and the 6-3 putout is money from Keegan Ball for the first out of this inning.
Stepping in, Aaron Newcomb. Newcomb singled his last time up, 1-for-2. And Paulo has already dialed in saying, put your Burrito Express order in for Saturday. My goodness. Look, I'm one of those guys, I'm going to be the first to admit, I don't need a lot in life. I don't need a pat on the back. I don't need someone to give me constant accolades. But if you feed me, it's a way to my heart. I'm a simple guy.
Yeah.
I have kind of those caveman needs.
Absolutely.
The simple basics of feed the famine.
Yep.
Take care of the need of hunger.
I'm on the same train as you, Joe.
1-1 count. And this one lifted down the left field line. That's going to bounce in. Newcomb on his way to second base. Mir McGee. And Newcomb on his way to third. Thought about it. Slowed up, and McGee holds him to a two-bagger, and that one's worked deep in that corner just past the bullpen out there. And Aaron Newcomb has got to be proud of his evening. Couple base knocks. Now 2-for-3 as Jake Petras steps in. Sack fly is last time up. And for Gavin Park in his fifth inning of work, Doc, the team has seen him now. The starting lineup is going into the third round. If you're Gavin Park, are you trying to show things on different pitch sequences to keep them off balance?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, especially, you know, second time and especially third time for Gavin Park. He's got to be switching things up, maybe starting to pitch backwards. And he's been pitching backwards all game. So for him, maybe it's switching it up and starting off with a fastball. But we go to a 1-1 count, and, I mean, either way, any sequence this kid throws is going to be pretty gross. So let's see what Gavitron brings right here. The 1-1 in the dirt.
Fastball misses outside, goes to 2-1 on deck as Luke Killinger, followed by Ryan Harness. Gavin Park trying to keep ACU in check. Solid outing for the sophomore. As we mentioned, only a couple innings of work this one. Keegan Ball getting a lot of work over there. Good hop and the throw over for the second out. And Doc, we've seen Keegan Ball. He's handling his business at short, showing the range and showing the glove work and the good velocity over to first base.
Yeah, I mean, a great showcase. And, I mean, these boys have been exciting all night long for Chandler Gilbert. And we're definitely going to see some new faces come next week in the lineup.
Luke Killinger stepping in 0 for 2. Takes one upstairs. Ball doing a nice job as ACU playing some pepper with him in that six hole. 1-0 count. Gavin Park wheeling and dealing. Misses outside. Roman at third base. Make that Newcomb at first base. 2-0 count. Harness on deck. This one fouled straight back. And Doc, we've yet to have one straight back right into the press box.
One of these days, Joe, one of these days. I might have to come back next year if we don't get one because I need to see it happen. It's only a matter of time.
So I was pushing for that. I think the lottery or the Mega Million was at $1.2 billion.
Yeah.
I play, of course, every week. And Doc, once again, if I win, this Chandler Gilbert baseball field and softball field, you name it, they're going to have everything and then some. New press box, stadium seating around so anyone can sit anywhere they want and enjoy it.
Yeah. I think that's a great idea. And I think we should have a jacuzzi in the broadcast booth as well. But in the meantime, Coach Pagel is going to have a quick chat with Gavin Park. And this is not something you see every day. Pagel looks a little confused on his walk out, but he's got the hold of things now. And let's see what he talks to Gavin about. Perhaps they're going to the pen, perhaps not. Perhaps just firing these boys up. But a funny moment for the Yotes here as Coach Pagel works his magic on the bump.
There is some activity in the Coyotes bullpen. And for Coach Pagel, it's not like it was a long ride from the dugout straight to the mound. So he didn't seem lost or confused. He seems like he's done it before, but maybe it's just been a while.
He's soaking it in, yeah.
I mean, it's almost like riding the bike all over again, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
You just got to, once you get back on, just get working the pedals a little bit and realizing it's all about, you know, moving the legs.
Yeah.
And look at Pagel.
Yeah.
He's cruising back to that dugout, and he's moving smooth and easily.
Yep. Like a pro.
So checking in, Ryan Harness. Harness, 1-for-1. Lays off a fastball. Harness smoked a triple in the second and walked in the third. He's got an opportunity and lifts this one, skies it to right. Jackson Reed coming in, and Reed hauls it in. ACU strand a couple. We go to the bottom half of the fifth. Coyotes with a 5-2 lead. So we're going to go to the bottom of the fifth. It's going to be Trey Medina, Amir McGee, and David Bull. And still on the mound for Firestorm is Alex Andrus. First pitch. Trey with a single in the first, struck out in the second. Big bender, and that one was a beauty by Andrus. Trey looking for another base knock and get the Coyotes going here in the fifth. And just gets a piece as Andrus working a little in and out.
Good in and out work. Now Mandina gonna have to bunker down and make something happen in the leadoff position.
And what about a solid first year for Trey Medina? This one's bounced to short. Throw over, and a good one. Good work by Aaron Newcomb to get Trey Medina. But Medina coming in, Doc, what a season he's having as a freshman. Hitting 381. That's some good work right there. And here's Amir McGee. And Amir is having a night and then some. Singled in the first, doubled in the third. Takes a slow bender for strike one. So, Doc, when I look at Gavin Park and I see Alex Andrus, it's almost like the same pitcher going at it with the same kind of skill sets.
Yeah.
Sneaky fastball, and then they come in with the big slow breaker.
A similar clash of pitchers today, and both of them have done well so far. This one hit off the pitcher's mound. The shortstop has it, and the throw over is money for the 6-3 putout. Amir is retired for the second out of this inning. But as you mentioned, yeah, two similar packages on the bump for both teams. And we'll see if David Bull can crack this one open some more.
And David Bull's 1-for-2. Got robbed of a hit in the first and singled in the third. Bull, limited opportunities, finding his way in his first year. Stepping in. And Doc, for freshmen, they get limited opportunities and maybe they don't have the success that they did in high school. How do they go about trying to keep the composure and realize brighter days will come?
Oh, good try from David Bull. But, yeah, I mean, anytime that you're going through a rough time on any part of the baseball diamond, you got to understand that baseball is a sport that demands a short-term memory. Whatever happens in front of you, apologies, whatever happens behind you is behind you. It's in the past. You cannot hold on to it or else you'll be in for a rough day. So short-term memory is the key to success in baseball and really one of the key aspects of cracking the mental side of the game.
So David Bull with the hustle to get down and beat it out for the infield single, and just an amazing effort by Aaron Newcomb on the throw over, the shortstop for ACU. DJ Barrett checking in. Pop to right and a sac fly RBI in the third. Takes one low off the turf for ball one. Barrett, the young man, the freshman right-handed pitcher, and look, he can swing it, Doc, coming in this one. He's hitting 385.
Yeah.
Granted, the at-bats are limited, 5-for-13 coming in, but, you know.
Yeah. I mean, this is one of the guys on the team that I think has a very, very bright future.
Let's correct ourselves. Checking in is Luke Doris.
LD.
LD. So Luke Doris checking in. Hitting for DJ Barrett. And oof. Doris coming into this one, limited at bats. He's still looking for his first hit of the year. Five at bats, still looking for that first one. Swings right through a fastball.
Great job to foul it off right there. Stays alive.
And a great job by the fan in the stands giving us the assist on letting us know that there was a change in the lineup. Now, we don't get the announcements, so if things are changed, we have to go on the fly. So it's called a very fluid situation, sort of like life. Every day, life's a fluid situation. How you adapt, go through the obstacles, put out the fires, and keep going. And deal with Mother Nature as well. And maybe your kids as well, who love you one day, and other days they don't. 3-2 pitch outside, and Luke Doris in the spot for DJ Barrett works the walk. So checking in, we know this is Blake Tiggs because he's number 5. So Blake with an opportunity. He walked and bounced into a rare 163 double play.
Yeah.
Anderson's glove on the hop to Newcomb, who threw over to first base. And Blake will take the bender off the body. So that loads him up. Good opportunity for the Coyotes to blow this one open. And checking in, Kyle Anderson. Oh for two on the night. Popped to second and a fielder's choice. And Alex, I'll take bullpen visits for 5,000, please.
So we'll take a sec while they sort things out on the mound. It's not going to be a pitching change, but a stern conversation for sure. We'll let them talk it out and be right back.
So Kyle Anderson, bases stacked. And if we would have known someone was going to make a polar pop run to Circle K, we'd have say snacks up here for the press box as well. So I got to tell you, us in the press box, we do everything for our fan base, and they know that. All we ask is if they make that run for food and hydration, they think about us just a tad. See, Dr. Perry comes prepared with his gallon of agua fria and his six-pack of chicken quesadillas.
Yep.
Yours truly, not so much. So here's Anderson with an opportunity to blow this one open. Infield playing up the middle. Outfield is playing fairly deep. 2-0 pitch. This one fouled straight back. And unlike most Chandler Gilbert games, we don't have that youngster tracking down the foul ball, running 150 miles an hour, trying to be the first one there.
Yeah, I think people are starting to catch on to the whole no snack shack thing, so maybe not as incentivized as it was previously.
Now, maybe Saturday, Doc, I might incentivize the youngsters.
Okay? Really?
Look.
Oh, boy.
If they get a foul ball, they come up to the press box, we'll have a little candy for them.
Okay.
How about that?
Yeah. Let's do it. Our own snack shack.
For the all, I'll just get a bag of candy. Could be Snickers bars. Could be Kit Kats. Could be Almond Joys. Big Bender by Andrus. And it's now 2-2 on Kyle Anderson. But that was part of the fun of going to the ballpark, you know, the little ballpark and getting the foul ball and running and getting the snow cone or something, right?
Yeah.
A little something for the effort.
Definitely.
Anderson, 2-2. That misses outside. So now Andrus has got to come to the zone. And Doc, is he going to give in or are we going to see another breaker here?
You know, I'd like to see another breaker here, but I think Kyle Anderson has seen it too often. So we might see a heater. We'll see what he brings. Payoff pitch.
Bender.
Wow.
And he locks up Anderson on the inside corner. So the Coyotes leave him loaded. We go to the 6-5-2 ball game.
Thank you.
So Gavin Park's time is done. Nice outing, five innings, two runs allowed. Now we turn it over to Justin Smith, the right-hander. We'll go to work, and Smith dialing in. Nine innings of work on the air. He's picked up one win, ERA of 4, 10 strikeouts, and nine innings of work. And Doc, give us kind of a resume on Justin.
Yeah, Mojo Smith, Justin, just an electric guy out of this Yodi pen. And he was here last year with the Yotes, didn't get too much action on the field. And this is a great opportunity for him to interject himself back in the pitching rotation heading down the last stretch of the season. I mean, he's got all the stuff to be a bona fide Yodi arm out of the pen. For him, it's just been a matter of consistency with throughout his outing. Sometimes he comes out of the gates hot and slows down. Other times it's the opposite, and Coach Watson and Coach Tyler have been trying to pull out the consistency from him and bring it to light. So far, off to a good start. 1-1 count for Mojo.
It's going to be Jacob Pickering, Josh Kazeel, and Stan King for the Firestorm here in the sixth inning. And this one smoked up the middle and right past Diggs. So a good piece of hitting by Jacob Pickering. ACU starting off their sixth in the right way. Kazeel checking in, reached on an error and grounded to short, 0-2 on the night. And Doc, other than handling all the business academically, have you been following Major League Baseball? Or have you been following the NBA?
I've been following both, Joe. I mean, I pride myself a little bit on being a bit of a sports fanatic, but, you know, it's been all right so far for my New York Mets. We've turned the corner a little bit after a horrendous start to the season, but obviously not off to the best start ever. This one fouled over the ACU dugout. And in terms of basketball teams, you know, a Suns bandwagon, if you will, but Joe, I wonder if you saw their terrible first quarter just a few days ago. They posted 8 points against the Clippers, who posted like 37 or something in the first. Just embarrassing stuff from the Suns, but that's how they are. Even with all big three on the court, sometimes they still struggle. Just inconsistent from them too.
Charles Barkley recently did an interview with 12 News and talked about the leadership or lack of from the Suns, and says the Suns are a soft team, and
yep,
I agree with them.
I agree.
I mean, look, starting three, most of the time they're like on a milk carton.
Yeah.
They're missing in action most
exactly.
of the time. I mean, you know, these guys can't stay healthy, and, you know, every other day someone's injured. And then, look, there's a physicality that, as Justin Smith gets the strikeout, there's a physicality that comes with basketball and a mental toughness that there is a lot of man-on-man defense, and sometimes you've got to own that and want to play good defense. And sometimes the Coyotes are, I should say the Suns are kind of like they're playing Ole defense and
yeah.
hoping to outscore the other team. And, you know, when you get to the postseason, as they're trying to battle to get there,
yeah.
Well, it's going to be a tough stretch if they get in, and, of course, trying to go on the road and beat teams. And it hasn't panned out the way ownership has wanted.
Definitely not. Runner takes off. A throw down for Mandina is on the money. But the ball gets away, and it might not have been in time. But for Mandina, that's awesome footwork behind the plate and a great strike down the middle. So nothing to hang his head about there.
Mandina with a quick release. Got out of the crouch and threw a dart, and ball almost got it. 1-1 count. Stan King at the dish. King 0-2 and looks at one to make it 1-2. So Justin Smith, he's got everything in the toolbox. It's just a matter of dialing it in between the ears, correct, Doc?
Absolutely. I mean, his stuff is gross. His fastball's been up to the mid-90s before. And pair that with a nice 12-6 from that high arm saw. This one is lifted well to deep right field. Jackson Reed tracking back at the fence. And this ball sneaks on over a home run. And just like that, this ball game has been pulled within one. ACU cuts the lead down. The score, Coyotes 5, Arizona Christian University JV 4.
Stan King getting all that one and reaching the cactus out in right center. That's about a 380 drive out there, and we've talked about it out here, Doc. The ball does not travel out here, so to get one out of here in the dead air,
yeah,
you've hit a shot and then some.
Yeah, tremendous. Tremendous shot right there.
So great work by Stan King, and checking in is Joey Thomas, 0-for-2. Takes a fastball, misses upstairs. So now a 5-4 ball game. Coyotes, of course, they're riding a 4-game winning streak. Would love to take another victory into tomorrow's big conference matchup on the road at Mesa. And here and out, they're all big. You can't take anyone for granted. Every game counts, and it's all about getting that top seed and trying to get right back here, Doc, to have that first round series right here. And then if you win that, you got the opportunity to win that final series and go to the Division II World Series in Enid, Oklahoma.
Yeah. Yeah, the Yotes are on the cusp right now. And listen, every time the Coyotes and Mesa play, it is like a World Series type of game on this field, and it'll be exciting to watch. Both teams are really going to go for it. And obviously, as we head down the stretch in the conference standings, they're close to one another. So 2-2 for Mojo. And he just threw a nice bender. We'll see if he doubles up. Heater fouled off straight back.
So since Paulo Hutchison is taking Burrito Express orders, Doc, I've never had a Burrito Express burrito.
Neither have I.
So I'm dialing in. So, Paulo, if you're listening, I want the mucho grande. If they have that, it's the mucho grande. That means it's mucho and it's grande and it's oh so bueno.
Yes.
I think they do.
Are you bilingual, Joe? That's tremendous.
Puedo yo hablo un poco español. Puedo muy despacio, no rápido. Puedo tú hablas Univision, yo entiende. Puedo me llamo José Pequeño.
Wow.
So there you go. That's about the extent of my Spanish, and I'm very disappointed I can't speak more. I should be able. I am. My mom is from the Dominican Republic. My dad's from Spain, and I speak un poco.
Yeah.
So if I was bilingual, I'd be calling games like ESPN Deportes, baseball,
yeah,
and soccer. And instead, I'm, you know, I got to dial in to Rosetta Stone for a session or two to get it all dialed in.
Yeah, Duolingo is calling your name. 2-2, fouled straight back.
Duolingo is an app, right?
Yes,
on your phone?
Yes. Correct.
Yeah. I almost used Duolingo to see if our Chandler Gilbert soccer team squad would go and pick us up something from Circle K. But I was... And that one bounces off the turf, goes to 3-2. Sunflower seeds, possibly.
Enticing.
And they're so, and they're
enticing.
So nice. Now they're like,
yeah.
I'm not trying to guilt them whatsoever.
Entirely. And a swing and a miss for strike three for Mojo. Justin Smith gets it done. A high heater is money for him. Now two down.
Alexi Roman checking in. He singled and bounced to short. And Doc, if you're watching a ball game, what is your favorite snacks? Is it seeds, or you chewing on bubble gum, or peanuts?
You know, it depends. If I'm in the dugout, it's definitely got to be seeds. It's got to be seeds or gum, something that I can chew, move my mouth around a little bit, keep me occupied. But if I'm in the stands, you know, sometimes it'll be sunflower seeds, but I don't mind a slice of pizza either, Joe, or a hot dog.
So if you're in the dugout, would it be Bubblicious or Big League Chew? Because Big League Chew was like, it was like, you know, almost like a big thing of tobacco, right?
Yeah, and that's a classic.
You pull it out, it's all stringy and everything. I love the Big League Chew.
Yeah, those were a smash hit, especially, you know, through the Little League days all the way up into high school ball. I mean, you can't go to a baseball field without seeing some Big League Chew. So they did their marketing pretty well. 2-1. Mojo. Leg lifts and deals. Heater misses a little inside. Take us to 3-1.
And I would always
Doc, I would chew like 10 pieces of gum. Like literally the gum, I'd have a big like knot.
I don't blame you.
On my cheek.
Yeah. Listen, the more gum, the better, because that just means you can blow bigger bubbles.
Absolutely.
So, this one, grounded foul down the third base line. Kyle Anderson is there, but he'll just get it right back to Mojo Smith to repeat this 3-2. So full count, payoff pitch is in order.
Lexi Roman working another quality AB. 1-for-2 on the night. No runners on, two outs here in the sixth. And he dials it up. Justin Smith gets Roman looking, and that's gonna do it. But it's a 5-4 ball game as Stan King drills a two-run shot. Coyotes coming up to swing the sticks in the lower half.
So I hope you enjoyed those tunes. Before we get back to work. And here we go, number 57 takes the bump for Arizona Christian University. And taking the box for the Yotes, it'll be number 3, Keegan Ball, to step in first. And here we go. So I'll wait for Game Changer to update the pitcher on the bump.
And that's going to be Angel Fregoso, hard-throwing right-hander. And Keegan Ball checking in. Keegan on the night. Popped to short, popped to left. Would love to get a hit tonight. And Doc, give us kind of the breakdown for Keegan Ball. Is it right now, swing away, try to make something happen?
Oh, the pullback on the bunt saves Keegan's life. Up and in heater, chases him out of the box. We go to 2-0, but for Ball, clearly he's just trying to show the coaches right now that he can execute the game plan, and if Coach Watson is calling for a bunt, it's a bunt.
So a 2-0 count, bottom half of the sixth for Gozo. And that one's fouled out of play. Angel Fregoso following lefty Alexandris. Now a 5-4 ball game. Kind of comes with that sidearm effect. Wheels across the body. Goes to 3-1. Aiden Krause on deck. And that one just fouled off, goes to 3-2. As we mentioned, Coyotes back at it tomorrow. Looking at the league standings, Chandler Gilbert, 16-12, leading Region 1. Mesa Community College, 16-14. Paradise Valley, 12-18. Scottsdale, 11-17. Glendale, 11-19. And that's a big bender that is off the plate by Fregoso. So good work by Keegan to work his way on. Now it's Aiden Krause. Aiden, 2-for-3. Bounced into a
double play his last time up. Showed bunt, and that one dials in for Gozo. It's kind of fastball that tails in on the right-handed batter, and both ball and Kraus rushed off the plate. Jackson Reed on deck, 5-4 ball game. Aiden Kraus stepping in. Shows bunt, gets one down, and he's gonna beat it out.
A beauty from Kraus.
And that's just great execution. Got a pass for Gozo as Alexi Roman, the second baseman, was gonna go cover first base. So give Kraus a single. And now it's Jackson Reed. 1-for-3, RBI single in the second. Takes one inside. So getting back to the league standings, PV 12-18, Scottsdale 11-17, Glendale 11-19, Phoenix College 10-20, and Gateway 10-20. But Doc, this is one of those things when you're a team like Chandler Gilbert, preseason ranked, you're leading Region 1, everyone wants to give you your A game, can't afford to take the foot off the pedal.
No, definitely not. It's full gas for the Yotes heading down the final stretch, and they know they have to finish strong.
Fregoso steps off the bump, resets himself. Now he's dialed in to his battery mate, Joey Thomas. Jackson Reed, couple ducks on a pond. Shows bunt, and this one fouled out of play on that third base line. And right now, John Watson, the coach of the Coyotes, wants to see his young men execute the small ball game, put runners in scoring position, and no question, as the games get bigger down the stretch, that's going to be an important attribute of this team being able to execute. 1-2 pitch. Oh, that's a bender, and Fregoso locks him up. Beautiful pitch. First out here in the sixth. Stepping in, Trey Mandina, 1-for-3. Singled in the first. And we kind of perused it, Doc. We kind of talked about Trey Mandina. And as a freshman catcher, there's so much to be asked for just to handle a battery mate and have that kind of nucleus with your pitchers. And then on top of it, young man stepping into this one was hitting 385. I mean, that just shows his savviness and poise to come in and deliver at the dish. And you can't stress enough having a great battery mate, having a great catcher behind the plate. It's the general directing traffic, directing the infield and outfield, and controlling the pitcher on the mound and keeping their emotions in check, making sure they're dialed in and working in harmony and in sync together. So Mandina, 1-1 count for Gozo. Wheeling and dealing, and that one's fouled down the first base line. For Gozo with that kind of arm whip across the body. He's got a 1-2 count. Mandina, he's got a big hole in that right side. Gets the bender and just gets a piece. So Fregoso in the early parts of this inning has shown a good fastball and that off-speed bender. He works on that outside part of the dish. Keegan Ball at second. Aiden Kraus at first, one out. 5-4 ball game. Fregoso in a battle against Mandina.
And Mandina, good poise, lays off. Mandina has done a lot of good work behind the plate and now having a quality AB. Looking for a pitch he can handle in the zone. Defense playing up the middle. 2-2 pitch, Bender. And that time, Mandina gets locked up and Fregoso, dynamite yet again. The Bender got Jackson Reed looking and Mandina as well. Now it's Amir McGee, a couple base knocks in this one for the Fighting Philly. Coyotes score 2 in the first, 2 in the second, 1 in the third. Held in check since. And Fregoso starts off with the Bender. Amir lays off. Good crowd on hand, of course. ACU, they bring their fan base from the I-17 area. Amir, high chopper to second base, and that eats up Alexi Roman. One run will score. The runner goes to third base. And Amir on the high bouncer that Roman cannot handle, knocks in a run.
So, I mean, McGee has reached safely three times today, two of which bona fide hits. That one depends who's the scorekeeper, of course. But, I mean, that's awesome stuff for him off the bench.
And that's a tough play for Alexi Roman because he has the runner from first right in his line of sight. And the only thing you could do if you're Roman in that play, drop step back and take that ball off your left part of your body.
Yeah.
And have a shot at it.
Yep.
Instead, he tried to come in and take the in-between hop, and those are always the toughest plays. So good work by Amir. Run comes in. Runners at the corners. Cruz. Make that Kraus at third, Amir at first, David Bull at the dish, and David on the night, 2 for 3. Got robbed of a hit in the first, singled in the third, singled in the fifth. Shows bunt, McGee casually goes down and steals second base. Coyotes were looking to draw that runner from third base home. Amir's second stolen base of the season. Fregoso on a 1-1 count. That Bender, and that one gets away. Coming in from third base, David Bull out of the way as Aiden Kraus crosses in. And what about the hustle by Aiden Kraus?
Yep.
That's a bang-bang situation. You got to decide on the fly, and Aiden Kraus saw the green light, and there was no hesitation in his game. Now makes it 7-4.
And the Yotes starting to pull away as they expected coming into this game, but, of course, the pitching of ACU has held up a lot longer than expected. And, of course, the Yotes still just trying to scrape together some runs. The man on third, Amir McGee, would be a wonderful addition to that. David Bull fouls this one over to the right side, right past the ACU dugout. So 2-2 now is the count with two outs. High-pressure situation here for Bull.
And Fregoso mixing that fastball with that breaking pitch, and now it's 2-2. And gets Bull waving. So Fregoso strikes out the side, but the Coyotes tack on a pair. They lead 7-4 going to the seventh.
I get those goosebumps every time you come around, yeah. You ease my mind, you make everything feel fine. Worry about those times, I'm way too numb, yeah. It's way too dumb, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time. I need that high, throw that to the side, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. When you're not around, when you throw that to the side, yeah. Get those goosebumps every time, yeah. 713 3281, yeah, I'm riding. Why they on me? Why they on me? I'm flying. I'm sipping low key. I'm sipping low key and honest. Find a rider. I
get those goosebumps every time you come around, yeah. You ease my mind, you make everything feel fine. Worry about those times, I'm way too numb, yeah. It's way too dumb, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time. I need that hype, throw that to the side, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. Pulling up right beside you, pop star Lil Mariah. When I text, get game wireless, throw a stack on the Bible, and I'm a Snapchat to the world.
So we go to the seventh inning. Justin Smith in his second inning of work. And ACU looking at claw back. They drew closer to 5-4. And now they go back to the top of the order with Aaron Newcomb. 2-for-3 in the night. A couple base knocks his last two time was up. And Justin Smith showing that slow bender over the top. 1-1 count. Smith working with Mandina. That time, high chopper to third. Great play and the throw over. And the hustle by Newcomb. And that's just a no-win scenario. And we've seen this, Doc. As the weather gets warmer, this field gets a little harder, you get those nuclear bounces, and that only benefits a hitter every single time.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, for Kyle Anderson, that's a play that if he had a few more in-game reps, he might have realized it was a do-or-die situation, but he sits back on it, gets a nice hop. Unfortunately, not enough time left to get the throw over. So a learning moment for him. Mojo picks back to first. Runner reaches safely. So no outs, runner on first. The leadoff man has done his job.
Stepping in, Jake Petras, followed by Luke Killinger and Ryan Harness. ACU, heart of their owner, looking to make some noise and trying to cut into this Coyotes three-run lead. Justin Smith trying to make the most of his opportunity out of the pen. Anderson on the infield grass at third. Big off speed. And Petras out in front. So you can easily see that Justin Smith's got a lot in the toolbox. Overpowering fastball, off speed, great movement. The skill set is there. 0-2 pitch. And gets Jake Petras swinging for the first out.
Beautiful pitch in the dirt.
Stepping in, Luke Killinger. Walked his last time up. 0-for-2 on the night. Defense playing straight away. Make that Petras with the single in the first. Was stranded, so he is 1-for-2 as Killinger checks in. Justin Smith given a three-run advantage. Now the 0-1 count. That one in the dirt. Outfield straight away. McGee in center. Kraus. Make that McGee in left. Kraus in center. Reed in right. Anderson at third. Keegan Ball at short. Tiggs at second. And Bull. Bouncer. And Tiggs goes to second for the force out. A little bit of a bang-bang play, but Tiggs knew he had some time, and that's the situation easily. Some players might have just went for the easy out at first base, but instead, Blake knew he had some time to kill and got it over to Keegan for the force out.
Yeah, anytime you can cut down the leadoff runner, you're a lot better off, especially now with two outs. Things become a lot harder for ACU to manufacture a run here with a man on first. Swing and a miss, first pitch. Mojo breaks out a changeup to go to 0-1.
So Ryan Harness, 1-for-2. He's also walked. Two outs for Justin Smith. Comes back with some gas, and that's across the knees. Goes to 0-2. And we are closing in on Justin Smith, trying to get through this frame and get us to the seventh inning stretch, where we will not sing Take You Out to the Ball Game, because we don't have the ability. If we had the microphone, possibly.
Yes.
But we don't. But we'll kick you with all kinds of jamming dance music. 1-2 pitch from Justin Smith. Brings the heat, and that one's fouled off by Harness. Harness has walked and smoked that triple and scored in the second inning. Off the wall and right, off Gavin Park. 1-2 pitch. Big bender and just gets a piece. So Ryan Harness really having a quality AB.
Just extending, being pestilent, and that's exactly what ACU is asking for out of him here.
Just trying to frustrate Justin Smith into a bad location. Justin tries to go inside, misses out of the zone. Goes to 2-2. Runner's going. Throw down by Mandina. And the runner gets in. Good hustle by Aaron Newcomb. Picks up the stolen base. So ACU trying to work the base path and get themselves in scoring position. Now it's up to Harness to deliver, and Justin Smith trying to find the equalizer to end him. And does that with the low heat. So Justin fires a perfect frame, and we go to the bottom of the seventh. Coyotes with a 7-4 lead.
Can't be sleeping, keep on waking, without the woman next to me. Guilt is burning, inside I'm hurting, this ain't a feeling I can keep, so blame it on the night.
Bottom of the seventh, and Luke Dorse in his second AB trying to get things going. He's down in the count against Angel Fregoso. Doris takes outside and Doris, 3-for-5 on the season. So limited at-bats for the young man as Russ Luce checks in, the AD of Chandler Gilbert. A man of many talents. He's everywhere on this campus.
Yeah, and you talk about people who would be great at broadcasting. I could listen to Luce talk all day.
Absolutely. And that's a fastball that eats up Doris for the first out, and Fregoso getting the firestorm going in the right direction here in the bottom of the seventh. Checking in, our good friend Blake Tiggs. On base percentage, close to 500 on the year. Always finds a way to get on base. Takes a big cut, comes up empty. Goes to 0-1. Blake on the night, 0-for-1. Infield, normal depth. And Fregoso starting to get into a comfortable groove on the mound.
And, you know, ACU came into this one prepared. They knew they had a Goliath in front of them with Chandler Gilbert. And, you know, I've been told they might have brought a few varsity guys with them. Fregoso, one of the varsity guys making the trek with ACU today. And, hey, bring it, man. Bring your best guys. Give us what you got. It's been a great matchup so far.
And for Fregoso, if he's not getting the work on the varsity stage, doesn't hurt for him to get some work down here and work on his craft and just build some confidence when he's ready to get on the bump for ACU. And Blake gives that one a ride, and that's tracked down by Killinger in left field.
Great barrel for Tiggs. Just hit it right at him. So nothing to hang his head about, but Kyle Anderson has a chance to pick him up now. Two down here in the bottom of the seventh.
So Luke Doris, who started this inning, still looking for that first base hit. He'll get it at some point, hopefully this year, as Anderson checks in. Anderson also looking for base knock, and this one bounced to short, throw over, it's a good one. And Newcomb and the Firestorm retire the Coyotes in order. We go to the eighth, a 7-4 Coyotes lead.
Rise up this morning, smile with the rising sun. Three little birds sit by my doorstep, singing sweet songs, oh, melodies pure and true, saying, this is my message to you. Don't
Thank you. We go to the eighth inning. Justice Smith back on the bump, holding a 7-4 lead. Stepping into the dish, Jacob Pickering. Base knock his last time up. 1-for-3 on the night. Coyotes call it a mid-season tune-up for the third quarter tune-up before getting back in league play, getting some players that might not have gotten some opportunities earlier a chance to get between the lines and get some playing time. So 1-2 count. Pickering with a sharp base knock his last time up. Outfield pretty much playing straight away. Kraus slightly shaded to left center. 1-2 pitch from Justin Smith. And Justin Smith wins that battle.
Yeah. Breaking pitch, off speed. Changeup right there and just fell right where he wanted. Beautiful work from Justin Smith. One down.
And we have a pinch hitter here. And I'm going to go deep into the archive.
Number 60.
And give me 1 second. And if you're wondering how we can have such great recall, it's because we take pictures of their roster and their lineups. And once again, that is Josh Cazell. And Cazell with a couple big hacks finds himself down in the count. 0-for-3 on the night. Justin Smith working fast, seems to be in rhythm. This one scorched to right. Jackson Reed going back. Reed won't get to it. That's going to bounce over the fence. And Cazell salvages his night with a opposite field double to right field. So the Firestorm looking to make some noise here in the eighth inning. Stan King checking in. Last time he left the yard, a two-run blast to right field. Saying hello to the cactus and desert environment out in right center. First pitch from Justin Smith, way off the plate. Justin Smith getting some extended work in relief of Gavin Park. 1-0 count. That misses outside. Goes to 2-0. Joey Thomas on deck, followed by Alexi Roman. Justin looking the runner back at second base, now locked in. Misses outside. So, Doc, it's looking like they don't want to give Stan King anything in the zip code to make this a one-run game yet again.
And rightfully so.
Stan King, the DH, he's showing bunt and pulls back, and he's not going anywhere. Home plate umpire says, come right back. And King was just trying to draw the free pass, and sometimes that can show him that bunt can break the concentration of a pitcher. That time for Justin Smith, he didn't do that. And Smith comes right back, fires.
Beautiful.
Another heater.
Now it's a battle, 3-2.
King versus Smith, Smith versus King. Runner at second base, 7-4, Coyotes lead. Payoff pitch. High bouncer. Justin Smith will go the easy route. Get him at first base. Good hustle by King down the line as Joey Thomas checks in with two outs. Thomas 0-for-3 on the night. Bounced into a double play, bounced to short, and is struck out. And you know he'd love to leave Chandler Gilbert with one good moment. One good base knock as infield now at normal depth. Outfield straight away.
Wow,
Justin
nasty.
Smith. And Doc, you've seen enough of Justin Smith. Is that his changeup essentially?
Yeah, and I think it might be his premier pitch, honestly, Joe. It's so good. He's been throwing it so often tonight, and I can't blame him. It's just been success after success. 0-1.
This one, sky to the right side. Second baseman going back, and how about Jackson Reed? We'll clamp that one down. So Justin Smith does the job yet again. We go to the lower half of the eighth. Coyotes with a 7-4 lead. So we go to the bottom of the eighth. Coyotes at the dish, and it starts with Keegan Ball. Walked his last time up. Also popped to short and popped to right. Angel Fregoso comes upstairs, misses for ball one. And Doc, you alluded to Fregoso on that varsity squad, maybe coming down here, getting some reps. He's got that big whip pan, comes as this one's lifted down the right field line, foul out of play. Pickering giving it a good run. But Fregoso gets good torque on that release, on that kind of sidearm delivery.
Yeah, I mean, makes his fastball play and makes his slider play off it even better, coming all the way across his body like that. And a very rotational athlete, as you can tell. He's bumping it up to right around that 90-mile-an-hour range. So explosive stuff on the mound for Fregoso. And there's the slider. That doesn't get a call, but it's a close pitch. We go to 2-1.
And that's wicked right there. Aiden Krause followed by Jackson Reed. Coyotes, two in the first, two in the second, one in the third, two in the sixth for a 7-4 lead. And Ball has worked the count to 3-1. Fregoso moving quickly. Comes right back, and he's not giving anything up quickly and easily. Fastball right down the plate. So now it's Keegan. Time to put his big boy pants on. 3-2 pitch. Bender lays off of it. And they say, they call him out, saying he did go. So Fregoso wins that battle as Aiden Krause checks in. Krause, a 3-for-4 night. Talk about checking the boxes in a big way. Freshman out of Corona, 286 coming in on base percentage, 446, and really tacking on. And this is a young man, Doc, that could be the starting center fielder next year for this Coyotes team.
Yeah, without a doubt. I mean, Aiden Krause has such a bright future. As this slider goes behind him, keeps his composure, doesn't budge an inch. We go to a 1-1 count, but for Krause, I mean, the physical attributes are there. He's a plus-plus speed demon on the base path. Great IQ on the base path. Defensively, he covers so much ground in the outfield. The only question for him is really just consistency at the plate. And, I mean, he's had lightning hot flashes this season. And he's had sustained flashes as this one hits off his leg. He'll take his hit by pitch and he'll take first base. But, I mean, Kraus is just a few at-bats away from solidifying himself in this rotation for the Yotes.
So he works his way down to first base. Now it's Jackson Reed. Jackson with a two-run single in the second inning. Part of his one-for-four night. For Gozo. This one skied out of play down the third base line. So once again, for all youngsters, I'm going to be packing candy. So
yes.
They go get foul balls. You come up to the press box. I will have some kind of chocolate goodness. I'll go pick up a bag of something on Friday. And I really hope, Doc, there's some kids here, because the last thing, as this one is thrown down, and how about the good stolen base by Aiden Kraus. Kraus showing the wheels and getting down to second base, advancing 90 feet, his 16th stolen base of the season.
And Joe, just to correct you real quick, it's Saturday that we get the matchup here. Friday, the boys will be away, but Saturday at noon here at Chandler Gilbert is where you can get some candy from the broadcast booth. Maybe not chocolate. It might be a hot day. We don't want some melted chocolate on our hands. We'll see.
Could be something.
Yeah.
It all depends on what I pick up.
Yep.
What is there? What is easy? What works well for the wallet?
Absolutely.
1-1 pitch. Jackson Reed. Fastball misses inside. And the weather is supposed to be picture perfect on Saturday, so good day. You want to catch a good team striving for big things. It's Chandler Gilbert as they're trying to make that push for the top seed in Region 1. And Fregoso misses inside. He's buzzed some Coyotes players off the dish. Now it goes to 3-1. Runner. Aiden Kraus at second base. Reed with the opportunity. Skies this one foul down the third base line. So yes, tomorrow the team's at Mesa, and then it's a return trip for the squad here on Saturday. 3-2 pitch. And Fregoso goes back to the slider. That's a nasty break on that.
Yeah. I mean, Fregoso, he's a varsity pitcher for this ACU squad for a reason. And he's showing it off here tonight. 3-2 now. Again, full count.
Kraus getting a lead at second base. Bender, and that locks up Jackson Reed. And that's the second out as Trey Mandina checks in.
So nastiness from Fregoso.
Mandina with a single in the first. Freshman catcher having a good year. Coyotes would love to get some insurance. Fregoso, as ACU was trying to work the back pick at second base. Newcomb doing a nice job over there, trying to keep Kraus close, playing a little cat and mouse game. Fregoso focused on just dialing up the gas, missing upstairs, goes to 2-0. Trey Mandina with an opportunity to get a base knock against a varsity pitcher. And ACU, that misses inside. So no, for Mandina, it's a short window, Doc. It's got to be something good in the zone. And on a 3-0 pitch, up 7-4, does he have the green light here?
I mean, honestly, he does. But with two outs, it'll be interesting. And he'll go ahead and take his base.
So, not a competitive pitch from Fregosa right there. And now runners on first and second with two outs. And Amir McGee, who's had a phenomenal night, gets another chance at the dish.
Okay, so Amir's 2-for-4. So that last time up, that hard ground ball to second base, the official scores gave it an E4.
Yes.
So we were hoping that Amir might have got that third hit with the luck of the scorebook, but needs to say, two-hit night is a good night. As Fregoso starts him off with some heat on the inside part of the dish. Amir fighting for playing time, and as you alluded to, Doc, a very crowded outfield for the Coyotes.
Yeah.
A very deep and talented outfield. That slider misses outside, goes to 2-0. David Bull on deck. Amir and a good hitter's count. Slider. And you gotta love the confidence of Fregoso to go back to his bread and butter and fire that slider even down in the count, knowing he can still get it across the plate. 2-1 pitch. Goes right back, and that time Amir lays off. Gotta love the patience by Amir.
Yeah, and this is, I think, the biggest difference for Amir McGee compared to the rest of the season. Tonight, he is just patient in the box. So, Joe, you hit the nail on the head right there. 3-1.
And that time.
He'll take his base on balls, and I don't think he knows quite yet that he has a walk. So a bit of a funny moment. Oh, no. Scoreboard is wrong. We're wrong up here in the booth. 3-1.
So it is a 3-1 count. We apologize for being human. We make mistakes
balked.
Too.
Apologies. There was a balk there that I missed. And we go to 3-1.
Okay.
Makes a lot more sense.
So Fregoso balked. Let's recap real quick as we pull all together.
Yeah.
Fregoso balked. Runners moved to second and third. And now it's a 3-2 pitch on Amir
there
McGee.
There we go. We're caught up. 3-2 gets away. Runner
gets away.
Will come to score.
And Aiden Kraus, once again, hustling down. And Aiden Kraus has been a dynamo in the base path.
Yeah.
He's done some great things. And you can tell his sophomore year here at Chandler Gilbert is going to be one to look forward to. So great at bat by Amir. Gets the walk. Another run is in. And sometimes, Doc, when things aren't going your way, you got to take the bull by the horns. David Bull checking in, 2-for-4 on the night. He's got runners at the corners and takes a fastball for strike one.
0-1. And Bull, so confident in the box. Takes a hack. This one is driven up the middle. Second baseman touches his own bag, and we are out of it. So two runners stranded for the Yotes. We head to the top of the ninth. Everything on the line right here for ACU. They've got to score four, or they're going home with a loss here tonight. We'll be right back into the top of the ninth.
Thank you.
You know, Doc, sometimes in life you just say, please don't stop. Please don't stop. Whatever you do, please don't stop the music. You just got to keep it going at all times.
Absolutely. Don't stop the music.
You just want the rhythm, the groove, the good harmony to continue.
Yeah. I agree, Joe. It's been a tremendous night here at the Chandler Gilbert Baseball Field, and the vibes are awesome here tonight.
Oh, so good.
Yeah.
Justin Smith got an opportunity to really close this one out, and Waddy wants to see Justin just finish what Gavin Park started. Gavin with a solid inning, only allowed two runs, and now Gavin Park looking to finish this one off. As Downey checks in, pinch hitter. Then it goes back to the top of the order with Aaron Newcomb. Downey hitting for Alexi Roman. Bouncer and good play for the first down.
Tiggs makes it look easy right there, and just like that, Mojo is back on his mojo. So again, five innings pitched from Park. And Justin Smith came out to start the sixth inning, and he's been great ever since. Four hits, two runs, and six strikeouts with no walks. It's been a tremendous outing for Justin Smith.
Now we go to the top of the order with Aaron Newcomb. 3-for-4 of the night. Takes a bender. And Newcomb making his case for varsity playing time. Poking three hits here in the East Valley. Fastball evens the count at one. And that's all you can do for a young man like Aaron Newcomb. Just go out there and try to impress and hit the weight room, stay even keel. And, Doc, would you say having an even keel mentality in baseball is one of the strongest attributes you can have, other than the physical skill, of course?
Yeah, I would say absolutely. You know, just the ability to keep working regardless of, we know what's happening in front of you or around you is just a huge, huge part of the mental game of baseball.
So it goes to 2-2. Jake Petras on deck. We appreciate you dialing us up right here on the Chandler Gilbert Sports Network. Justin Smith misses inside. A lot of great games left on the schedule. Not just for the men, but for the women's softball team as well as they look for a playoff berth. That one's fouled off straight back. And the great thing about Chandler Gilbert, you can bring your dog to the ballpark.
Yeah, 100%.
Right in that third base side, right by the dugout. Little pooch is here, and this one's sky to right field. Jackson Reed going back. Reed brings it in. For the second out, Newcomb gave it a ride. Now it all comes down to Jake Petras. And we might have a pinch hitter here as well, stepping in as we go deep into the scorecard. It's a pinch hitter. And we'll get a name for you after the first pitch. Trevor LePray checking in. Our crack staff giving us the information. LePray stepping in for Jake Petras. Petras was this one bounced over, and they'll flip over, and that's not going to get it done. So Coyotes getting an error on that right side. So the inning continues as David Bull on the mishandle at first base. So LePray, the pinch hitter, works his way on. At the dish, now it's
number 50. And we'll go back into the, this is going to be Brian Garcia. And Brian Garcia, and we're easily, I don't know, about 100 feet away or so at a higher altitude looking down at Brian Garcia. And Brian Garcia, Doc, is thick.
Yes.
So if he hits the ball,
it'll go.
It's going to have some velocity behind it. 2-0 count from Justin Smith. Now dials it up right there. Justin Smith's like, okay, hitter's count. There you go.
Yeah.
Put one on a platter.
That's the pitch if you're going to hit it.
Yeah. Now a 2-1 count. Comes back, just misses outside, goes to 3-1. Ryan Harness is scheduled on deck, and Harness is on deck. 3-1 pitch, and that misses outside. So Harness steps in.
And now would be a good time for him to harness his hitting potential and bring it all to fruition. He's had a good day so far today, and he looks to make it sweeter with this at-bat. Two outs, runners on first and second.
Yeah, he tripled in the second. He walked in the third. Also struck out, having a good night. Takes a big cut. It's not getting cheated. And, Doc, if you're going to go down, you go down hard. You go down swinging, right?
Yep, on your shield.
You're not going to go down looking. You're going to give it all you got. As a wise man who does weather in the White Mountains once said, make it count. 1-1 pitch, Harness. That's a slow tapper, fouled off. So it goes to 1-2. Smith was some theatrics out there. Throws the ball away, gets a fresh rawhide. Now he's got Harness exactly where he wants him. Runners at first and second. 1-2 pitch to Harness. And Justin Smith misses low, evens the count. Jacob Pickering on deck. Smith working quickly. High chopper, and that one's going to be foul. So Harness not getting cheated. He's going to go down. He's going down battling. He's going down with a purpose. 2-2 pitch. Coyote is going for win number 28. Here it is. Bender, and that locks up Harness. And Smith gets the job done out of the pen as the Coyotes handle the ACU JV by the count of 8-4. And Doc, it started with a good outing by Gavin Park.
Yeah, I mean, Gavin Park took the mound, gave the Utes exactly what they were looking for. 5 innings of work for Gavin Park, 2 runs allowed. And, I mean, it was just awesome stuff for him. Tone-setting work for him and potentially leads to a great rest of the season out of the bullpen. And Justin Smith picked up, did not leave a beat from where Gavin Park left off. And I mean, these boys work together, dynamic duo, and they shut down ACU tonight.
Jackson Reed with a big 2-run single in the second. Coyotes tacked on 1 in the third, 2 in the sixth, and 1 in the eighth, and they get the 8-4 victory, so they improve to 28-14. And Doc, they've won 5 straight.
Yeah, 5 straight wins for the Coyotes, and they're just picking up more steam with every single game that passes by. 4 of those being conference matchups, of course. This one tonight, a little bit of a step down in pace, you could say, but still, these Yotes played like it was a conference game and pedal to the metal the whole game. It was awesome stuff, and it leads us right into tomorrow's matchup against Mesa.
And that's a big matchup. Chandler Gilbert currently leading all Region 1 teams with a conference record of 16-12, and of course that game is at Mesa tomorrow. And if you're looking to make the trek over to Mesa, and we encourage all Coyotes fans to root on the team. That game is at 3 o'clock at Mesa Community College, and then it's return matchup Saturday at noon. The doctor and I will be here to call it. Paulo Hutchison will be here with Burrito Express. And once again, Paulo, the burrito mucho grande bueno. That's for me. And I think the doc wants one as well. So we are good from here. Coyotes get the victory 8-4 at Mesa tomorrow, and they're back here on Saturday. We appreciate all the good people at Chandler Gilbert, like AD Russ Luce, allowing us to bring you the latest and the best from Chandler Gilbert Athletics. And, of course, a great honor and pleasure to call the games for Coach John Watson and his great team. For our great staff, Adam Perry, Thunder Dan, working the equipment, as always, like a champ. I'm Joe Pequeno. Good night for the Coyotes with the 8-4 victory. We'll see you on Saturday when Mesa comes to town for a noon first pitch.